Hi, I'm Craig Reed with Armada Technologies. Today we're going to troubleshoot and use the Pro 900 Advanced Valve Wire Locator to trace two wire systems and show you how to detect decoders with the wand, the receiver itself. The digital output on the receiver gives us a numerical value. There's a number associated with your frequency strength that goes down the cable. So by using that frequency strength, when we go over decoders, it's going to come up and then go back down to a number. It's just a number. It doesn't have to be the same number all the time. So what we do at the controller, we're going to disconnect our two-wire path from the controller. We're going to take our two leads on the two-wire path, and we're going to put them together, twist them together, and we're going to connect our red lead from the advanced Pro 900, and we're going to send the path of frequency down the wire. So when we start our machine, we're going to try to keep it as low as we can. We don't want the machine to really be loud. We want to be able to be sensitive to the frequency itself. So in the null mode, as I go across, when I'm on top of the wire, I get a zero reading, and then the noise you can hear. So with zero, then it goes up to 44, zero, 44. And as I go down the path, I'm going to be marking my path. You have to mark the path of a two-wire system no matter what you're troubleshooting. If you don't know where the path is, it's going to be difficult to tell how far down the path something might be. So we want to make sure we mark it as we go through this process. As we go through, I'm marking where I've been so I can turn around and see where I've been. But as I go across, that number is going to move. And right now, as I go across a decoder, it's getting louder. You might be able to hear, but I can see a number that's jumping. So I'm going to back off of that decoder. I'm going to go to peak mode. Again, turn the unit down as low as I can to get a reading. And I'm going to go straight over the path of wire. Right now, it's reading 33. As I go across the path, it's reading up to 44. And now I go back down, it's reading 33. So as I went across this field, it's giving me a higher reading. That higher reading is telling me that there's something there. It could be just a good splice too. You might be able to pick up the splices that aren't marked. That's happened before in the field. So as we go down in our null mode again, we found that decoder. We're going to keep going down. As we come down our path, we're going slow. You have to be patient. This equipment is 30% science, 70% skill. You got to get used to these. So we're going to go down the path, and we keep going, and we know where the path is. And of course, we're above ground for simulation, so you can see where everything is. But as we come across something, it's going to change. The numbers are going to come up. Now back here, I'm reading 18 and about 14 on the side, zero in the middle in a null mode. So I'm going to go to peak because I saw it pop up over that. Turn it down as low as I can. And as I go down the path, now the sound is going to be loud over everything that it's on top of. And as I go across, the number is now up to 35 here. As I go beyond it, it's going down to 32, 28. The other thing the 900 does is if you have a broken wire, the sound's going to carry through the earth because it's a fault to earth. So as I'm going down, and I've got the sound down a little bit too low, it's going to bleed out, but with the digital, it just ends. So if that was a broken wire, we'd know within maybe a foot of where that broken wire is. So it does a lot of features on the two-wire system. It's going to be able to pick up splices, and once you get used to it and you use all of the features on it, you'll be able to locate decoders. Again, it's 70% skill. It's going to take a little bit of time to get used to it, but it's going to help you out a lot.